The Scarecrow and the Tin Woodman brought up the rear, and before they had gone many yards, a joyful shout from Jack announced that the way was clear before them. They all paused to look backward. Not a trace of the field of sunflowers remained. More cheerfully now, they proceeded upon their journey, but old Mombi had so changed the appearance of the landscape that they would surely have been lost had not the Scarecrow wisely concluded to take their direction from the sun, for no witchcraft could change the course of the sun, and it was therefore a safe guide. However, other difficulties lay before them. The Sawhorse stepped into a rabbit hole and fell to the ground. The Pumpkinhead was pitched high into the air, and his history would probably have ended at that exact moment had not the Tin Woodman skillfully caught the pumpkin as it descended and saved it from injury. Tip soon had it fitted to the neck again and replaced Jack upon his feet. But the Sawhorse did not escape so easily, for when his leg was pulled from the rabbit hole, it was found to be broken short off and must be replaced or repaired before he could go a step farther. "This is quite serious," said the Tin Woodman. "If there were trees nearby, I might soon manufacture another leg for this animal. But I cannot see even a shrub for miles around. And there are neither fences nor houses in this part of the Land of Oz," added the Scarecrow disconsolately. "Then what shall we do?" inquired the boy. "I suppose I must start my brains working," replied His Majesty the Scarecrow, "for experience has taught me that I can do anything if I but take time to think it out."